Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a video using the new Subculture palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills herself. I've heard mixed reviews about this palette. This palette is... we just have to find out. I created this eyeshadow look with it, and that's basically it. Her shades are pretty beautiful and very wearable, very fall-like. So love this. If you guys want to see how I created this look and how I feel about this palette, then please keep watching. This is how the palette looks. It's like a suede material, just like the Modern Renaissance palette. And here's the beautiful colors. So I sat for some time looking at this palette and I'm like, okay, what shades do I want to use on my eyes? Because they're all very nice, but I'm like, I don't know what type of like eyeshadow look to do. Like, I see some neutrals, some earthy tones, some pop of colors, and then metallic shades. Only two at that. So I'm kind of like, okay, what do I want to do? So I know for a fact that I want to use this peach shade right here, which is called Roxy. I want to use Fudge, Destiny, and Dawn, which are these three shades right here. Alright, so I know I'm going to use those shades. And you guys are probably tired of me doing cut creases, but I love cut creases. So this is going to be another cut crease video. If you don't like it, I'll tell you, I love cut creases. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna use Dawn, Destiny, Fudge, and Roxy. And I'm gonna be doing a few tutorials using this palette because you can definitely create some fall looks with these dark shades right here. This is like a very fall kind of palette. But yeah, let's get started. I already put some concealer on my eyelids as primer. Just gonna blend it out because it's creasing a little bit. What else? What am I gonna start with? Okay, so I'm going to go in with my... if I can find the brush, that would be awesome. Is that up here? So I'm going to be taking my Morphe Y19 brush. If you hear a dog barking, it's someone's dog outside. I'm just gonna ignore it. I think I'm actually gonna try to use the brush in the palette just to see how it looks, because this is all about the palette. This is gonna be nothing but honest reviews, honest, you know, opinions that I have about it. No lying here. So let's get started. I'm going to take Dawn, which is the shade right here. And I'm going to be putting that into my crease, using that as my transition shade. It's very pigmented, so I'm going to dust it off, take this, and begin. Just reapplying. Now this time, the second time I tapped into it, there is some fallout. And right now, I'm not dusting it off. Only for the first try, I like to dust it off. Just because I want to see how pigmented the product is. That's that. Okay, I think I'm going to zoom in. So, taking that, and I'm going to, for the other eye, tap. So that's how it looks like when it's like just like a tap and a little bit of eyeshadow. Now I'm not going to tap it at all, and I'm going to apply it, and I get more color payoff. So there's fallout when I tap in the palette, but there's no fallout like on my face. So I really don't know what people are talking about so far. I'm gonna show you the fallout. See how it has like little like dust particles on here, like not dust sparkle, like eyeshadow pieces. I don't know if you can see it, but it's on there. So far, I really like this shade. Very neutral, very peachy and nice. Okay. Now I'm going to go in with Destiny, which is this olive shade right here. And I'm going to be putting that in my crease very lightly. I'm going to tap that off and do it very lightly. No, I'm not tapping at all. I'm doing like circular movements all around. And then I'm gonna like move it up a little bit. You guys can see like up close. I applied more. And I do like circular motions back and forth all around the crease. A little patchy. I'm gonna go back in with Dawn and kind of like blend that together. I don't know. I'm really just gonna build up that olive shade because I really want this shade to show in my cut crease. Taking Dawn and blending that out with the olive. A little bit. I'm gonna repeat the same steps on the other eye. Now we have two eyes done. So far it's okay. It's okay. Like it looks a little chalky in person. I don't feel like the olive shade is dark enough. As much as I keep applying it, it kind of looks like a cool grayish tone. So I'm gonna go in with Untamed, which is this right here. It's like a bluish olive shade. I'm gonna see if that works. Yeah, that's better. That just deepens up the crease a lot more. Back in with Dawn and kind of blend all of that together. I think it's okay. Now I'm gonna go in with Fudge, which is this brown chocolatey shade. And I'm going to take a different brush for this. I'm going to use my Morphe Y22 brush. It's like a really small crease brush. And I'm just going to apply this in my crease. I don't like how that looks. All right. Screw that. I'm gonna fix that with Untamed. Well, you know what? Actually, no. Change my mind. I'm gonna go back in with Fudge because it actually darkens my crease a lot more. And since my lid shade is gonna be Roxy, that peach shade, it's gonna make Roxy pop out. So I'm actually just gonna take Fudge and just put this right here. It's okay. Sigh, sigh. Where's my concealer brush? Okay, so I'm gonna go in with the Anastasia concealer in 0.5. Take a little bit. And I'm going to carve out my crease. Wait. So that's the first crease cut done. All right, now we're gonna take, I'm gonna use the brush that came with the palette. I'm gonna use like the flat end, and I'm going to take, see, this is giving me like fall vibes. Like I kind of want to go in with Adorn now, this like shimmery shade. No, I'm gonna stick to Roxy. I'm gonna take Roxy. I'm going to press on to the areas that I carved out. Oh yes. Oh, what? What? Oh. OMG. Wow. You guys, this shade. Oh. Oh yeah, this is wonderful. Yes. Oh, this is so pretty. I'm gonna use my Morphe Y21 brush, which is like very square and flat. Let's see if that can get up there. Okay. Alright, going back in with my Y22 brush, I'm going to take Fudge and define my crease. I think that I'm gonna add some glitter into my crease. BRB. All right, so I'm going in with my, oh, I just ran out of breath. I had to answer the door because, is this breakage? What? Anyways, I had to answer the door because my Morphe package came, my Jaclyn Hill palette. Super excited. Anyways, so, okay. I'm going to be using the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter in Midnight Cowboy. I love this glitter. Excuse me. If I had a different glitter, I would use like a pink one. But instead, I'm going to use this one. So I'm going to put that in my crease. Let that dry, and then I'm going to do the other eye. Mm-hmm. now while this eye, the glitter is drying, I'm going to go in with my eyeliner by Tarte, and it is the Tarte Tease eyeliner. And we're just gonna do like a simple wing eyeliner that I always do. Now that is done. For primer, I'm going in with my Baby Skin Maybelline Instant Pore Eraser. This is pretty inexpensive. I think it's like $6 or $7. I don't remember. I'm going to use this on the areas that I get oily, just like everywhere. And I'm just gonna like push this into my skin. Lately my pores have been like super large, and I think it has to do with the weather and maybe it being summer. It's like literally so annoying. I try like mad different foundations all this summer and none have seemed to work out. I'm breaking out like crazy. It's so annoying. Literally cannot stand it. So that's that. Now I'm going to be taking the new, well, it's not that new, but I haven't used it before. It's the Anastasia Stick Foundation in the shade Golden. Just bought this yesterday. I'm about to use it for the first time. Hopefully I like it. I was told to use this with like a brush that's like a flat brush, foundation brush that like buffs everything out. Yeah, I'm just gonna mark this on my face. I've never used a stick foundation before, so this is literally the first time. This is like literally the first time for everything in this video. Right, so I'm going to be taking my Morphe R6 brush and I'm going to buff everything out. Okay, so far, this effing foundation has no type of full coverage whatsoever. This is very patchy. Did not cover any of my dark circles. I meant my blemishes. Like, what is life? I gotta put like mad layers on. So I guess you could say it's buildable, but I don't like foundation that I gotta keep building and building and building. Like, I just want to do one fucking layer. That's all I want to do. Who is texting? Damn, nigga. I already have a lot on. They said not to use a beauty blender with it. I'm using a beauty blender. Yeah, this is so much better. Why are people telling me to not use a beauty blender with it? Alright, so I can already tell this foundation is ass. I'm sorry, Anastasia, this foundation is ass. Yeah, I don't like it. I had to put like 3 layers of this on. I can already tell that it's gonna separate. I can tell. I already know. I see my breakouts coming through. Like, oh my god, like look at this. This camera smooths a lot, but breakout. Still see it. Still see it. I have breakouts here, like, on camera it looks flawless, but in person it looks like shit. Whatever. I'm gonna go back in with a concealer and I'm going to conceal under my eyes. I love her concealer, but I don't like her foundation. I really thought I was gonna like it. Like, I swatched it on my neck yesterday at Sephora, and I'm like, okay, like, this matches my skin perfectly. Like, hopefully I like this. It's affordable, like, I hope I like this, and I don't. What are you gonna do? Anywho, I have a lot of concealer on, but we're gonna blend that out. I will say though, like, the concealer blends in the foundation nicely, so that's not bad. The concealer is pretty light on camera, but it's not this light in person. But I do like a bright under eye, especially when I have like a dramatic eye look like this. It's the best to use or to go for. Everything's blended pretty nicely, I will say that. All right, now I'm going to use my Too Faced Born This Way setting powder. I just bought this. I heard nothing but good things about this. I've used it already for like the past few days, and it's very lightweight, which I love. Comes with a lid like this. Just gonna take some there, so it looks like that. I'm going to take my Beauty Blender and set my under eyes. That's a lot. That's setting. I'm going to use my Morphe Y4 brush, and I'm going to bronze and contour using my Too Faced bronzer. To contour my nose, I'm taking the Morphe E45 brush, which is like this, and I'm going to contour. Setting powder and just set the size of my nose. So I'm gonna take my Morphe R13 brush. I'm just gonna wipe away under my eyes. And the sides of my nose. Ow, I poked myself in the eye. Shit. I think I'm going to apply a little bit of Dawn on my waterline. Something warm under the eyes. Now I'm gonna go in with the Tarte Fake Awake liner. And I'm going to apply this on my waterline. For mascara, I'm going with the Marc Jacobs mascara. For blush, I'm going to go in with the Tarte blush in Party, which looks like this. Take a little bit of that. Ooh. Yep. Now I'm gonna go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in Sun Dipped. And I'm gonna be taking all of the shades. I'm gonna be using the Morphe M500 brush, which looks like this. This brush is so good to use for highlighting. But let me tell you why. Watch. It evenly distributes the highlight on the highest points of my cheeks. And not only that, but it does it in a very smooth manner. Like, super nice. I'm going to go in with World Beauty lashes. These I got from Amazon and they are so beautiful. These are mink lashes and they're very fluffy, very soft. Look how beautiful. So I'm going to apply these lashes off camera and then we'll be right back. Okay, so the lashes are on. For lips, I'm going to go in with, this is Smoke by Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's part of her like new matte lipstick line. It looks like this. It's super pretty. Very perfect for the fall. And then I think to top it off, I'm gonna go in with Gilded on top just to kind of go in with like the shimmer and the glow of my face. I kind of want to add some shimmer to my lips. So yeah. To outline my lips, I'm gonna go in with Cork Lip Pencil by MAC. Wow, this lip color is beautiful. I will say though, it's like sticking on to like my dry skin on my lips. It's not a bad lipstick at all. It's very creamy. I just have dry lips right now. But this is beautiful. Thinking if I want to keep my lip color like this. I think I'm gonna add a little bit of Gilded on my lips. Yeah, I fucks with it. I like it. So this is a completed look. I'm so surprised that this tutorial came out pretty well. A very long tutorial, but what I have to say about this palette, I don't see anything wrong with it. I don't. Yeah, I really don't see anything wrong with it. The eyeshadows are very, very pigmented. Her lipstick is bomb. I just didn't like her foundation that I tried out. I had to put on like mad layers, which I did not like because I usually only like to use a few layers when I put on foundation. It blended out nicely with the Beauty Blender and it worked well with her concealer. What else? Other than that, her palette is bomb. Definitely go get it. I'm so happy it came out pretty good. So I'm going to show you a close-up. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you've watched all the way to the end of the video, thank you so much, because I know this video is going to be very long even when I edit this video. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. I will definitely be using this palette to do more like fall looks, because fall is coming like right around the corner. September is in like a few days, like 5 days I think. Yeah, stay tuned for that. I just got the new Jaclyn Hill palette, so you know it's lit. I'm about to do a tutorial on that. A couple of tutorials on those. I got a lot in store that I want to do. But yeah, I really love how this look came out. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Yes.